In today's Madden 21 tip video, I'm going to be breaking down a solid three-man pressure that you can utilize out of the 3-4 bear formation to not only get good pressure with your quarterback, but to have really good coverage behind it. What's up, guys? My name is Cody, and I want to thank you so much for taking the opportunity here to just catch one of my YouTube videos. I post 4 videos a day here on YouTube with some type of tactical, strategic, or conceptual tip that you can utilize to really help you win more games in Madden NFL 21. So if that's something that interests you, what I want to encourage you to do right now is go to the bottom right of the screen and click the subscribe button, and right to the right of it, there's a little bell icon. And what I would ask you to do is to turn on all or personalized notifications, because we live stream every single night at 10 o'clock Eastern time, and I don't want you to miss one of those streams. Would love to have you come hang out with the clan over there. Really, really great time. All right, so we're talking 3-4 bear, and I got a question in the live stream actually about this blitz, and I didn't realize that I hadn't posted the updated version for it. So basically what you want to do is you want to put your fastest guys in. I like to put Winovich as a nose tackle on the Patriots, and then you can also put at the right screen end, put Derek Rivers there. So these guys have pretty decent acceleration, but this is a three-man disengage blitz. So what I like to do also, real quick, for those of you guys that want to turn this into a whole scheme, whole defense, you want a basin line, turn option defense conservative, tackling to aggressive. Now, right here, you want to put your flats, okay? You want to put your flats at about 5 yards. Curl flats, I like to put those at 20, and hook curls, I like to put those at about 10 yards. And you'll see how this completely will box a lot of the passing sets that you'll see in this year's game. The play we're going to be doing this out of is the play cover 3. All right, all we're going to do from this is we are going to pinch our defensive line, crash our defensive line down, and QB contain, and you'll see that the blitz is set up, and you will typically get these really fast disengages. Of course, with my luck, oh, I'm sorry, I forgot one step to tell you, my bad. The other key element to this, and actually is really good, especially if you're facing like a mobile quarterback, but you're gonna crash your line down, pinch them, QB contain rush, and then what you're gonna do is you're going to take this rightest screen linebacker, and you're gonna put him on a quarterback spy. And what you'll see here is at the snap of the ball, there's that disengage, and you see you're going to get that instant shed, instant win. Now, I know that a lot of people have been talking about this and have been posting this video over the course of the last couple of weeks, but this is post-patch, and they said, I think I actually have been running this for a while. I just haven't shared it with anybody, honestly, because I think I thought I already did. But anyway, that's the blitz setup. What we're going to do right now is we're going to show you the coverage. So you see there, I mean, just completely glitchy, disengaging pressure. Now, I want to show you two things. First and foremost, I want to show you how to stop it. All you have to do is audible to a play-action play. So you see here, I'm going to audible to play-action read out of gun spread, and just put the running back on a route. You don't even have to use him really for the play. But what you'll see here is the disengage blitz. Actually, man, it does come in. You might need to leave the play-action on. I'm sorry. But 3-4 bears by far the best, in my opinion, for this specific blitz setup. And that's why we really included this in our defensive guide as well. Is not only is this, and there you see, this does pick up the disengage, and then you're able to throw it to whoever you want. But now what I want to do is I want to show you some a coverage concept that you can utilize with this that's going to make it fairly effective. So again, the setup for the blitz is to crash your line down, pinch them, QB contain, and then spy this right of screen linebacker. From there, all we're going to do is we're going to set up a Mabel coverage on this right side of the screen. So I'm going to do a shade coverage down, shade coverage up to get flat zones, and to make sure that those deep thirds stay over top. You can also turn those into deep halves. I actually really like to do that. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this linebacker on the right side of the screen, put him in a purple zone. The safety, I'm going to drop him into a hook curl, and typically I'll move him over to the right just a little bit, or I might just user him, honestly. You can just use them if you want to. And then on the right side, what I like to do is just run a standard coverage. You could run Mabel coverage, or what you can do is you can do, you know, basically something like this right here, where you have pretty decent crossing route protection, but if they run to the flats to the right, you're going to get it. But this is going to turn it into a decent coverage, and this is actually fairly good coverage for the pressure that you're going to get. You know, just a great way to run 3-4 bears. So let me go over the setup one more time for this. Literally all I'm going to do, and what you can do if you want, is you can actually show blitz. And what you'll see by showing blitz, it'll actually naturally bring these guys down. But what you'll see here, literally all I'm going to do is crash my line down, QB contain rush, and then I'm going to spy this right screen guy. Now, he's going to take away underneath drags and everything on that right side, so I'm almost going to not necessarily need a yellow zone. And then just shade coverage down and shade coverage up. What that's going to do is it's going to put the flats out there. And then what I like to do is I like to just throw two purples, or if you want to have a hook curl, you can. But I actually really like the Mabel coverage this year, because what this is going to do, honestly, is it's going to make it a little bit more challenging for your opponent to just throw these snap throw streaks, because you're going to be able to get catch tackles for days out of this. You're also going to be able to, you know, just force them to have to work the ball up the field. You'll be surprised at how well zones are starting to play now, especially in Mutt, how we're getting better cards every single week. And if you do something like this right here, where you bring the bear defense element to it, but what I like to do is make sure that these two guys over the middle have fairly good coverage. One other thing you could do is throw him into a deep quarter, actually really like that, and then throw that purple out there. And then what that's going to do is you got Mabel on one side, you got a purple to the other side. Now they've got one side where they can throw flats, the other side they can't, and then you're just lurking in the middle. And as you can see, that spy, actually, because it's from a linebacker, will sometimes play things over the middle. But again, you just want to master your lurk, master your user with this, and this could be a pretty good defense for you. And the cool part is you could do it from anything. So what I can do is I could audible here to cover one hole. Literally same thing, I'm base aligned, I'm pressed, and I'm just going to move this guy in. Now I'm in man-to-man coverage, and you'll see here, now I've got this standard set, setup. All I'm going to do with my linebacker is just man him up. I'm going to man my safety up on the running back. I'm going to drop my linebacker into a purple zone, so now we don't have to have worry about crossing routes on that side of the field. Drop my other linebacker into the spy, so the blitz is set up, and now I'm running cover one with the best of them. This is the best three-man blitz for a cover one, and you're in man-to-man, right? No win. I mean, just an amazing way to do this. So that's 3-4 bear, disengage pressures. Just wanted to show that to you. If you guys enjoyed this video, go ahead and leave a like rating. Also, I want to encourage you to jump in the Discord. We have a whole section of Discord that's actually devoted to people sharing their setups, people sharing some of their favorite plays, some of their favorite play concepts, people sharing counters to the meta. Maybe you're struggling against this, or maybe you're struggling to stop the run or whatever, right? Go to the Discord, throw that in the Discord. People will help you, and it's not just going to be me. It's going to be other people as well who are well-equipped and well-trained in this game. If you guys want to pick up the defense and really take your game to the next level, I want to encourage you to do that as well. You can pick that up in the description of this video. I got some other videos that are going to come on the screen right about now, but as well as a live stream tonight at 10 o'clock Eastern time, and we will be sharing another video on our channel here in a few hours. So be sure to subscribe. Be sure to be checking the channel every single day, because we got 4 videos a day coming for you, as well as nightly live streams at 10 o'clock. I'd love to see you at the live stream tonight. And if you have any Madden questions, for sure, feel free to always be willing to text me. My number's at the top left of every video I do, 812-216-3644. See you guys.